Hey, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Sawyer Center on the campus of Southern Nazarene University. Southern Nazarene Crimson Storm basketball is on the air. This afternoon, the Crimson Storm back at home after a three-game road swing, taking on Southeastern Oklahoma State. Hi, everyone. Luke McConnell here with you in the Sawyer Center. Delighted to have you with us for more great American Conference basketball. We are halfway through. Today marks the second half of the Great American Conference season. Hard to believe we are already at the end of January. The next game on Thursday here at the Sawyer Center will be February. Hard to believe we're already here as the Crimson Storm women and men look to win once more after getting a sweep on Thursday out in Shawnee against rival Oklahoma Baptist. First up, we'll start with the women. Number four in the nation in the coaches' poll, number one in the nation in the media poll. They are 17-0, have won 18 straight here at the Sawyer Center, and 31 consecutive regular season games dating back to January of 2023. It's been a full calendar year since SNU lost a regular season game, and they continue to do it in a variety of ways. The biggest storyline for the Crimson Storm women at this point is the return of senior Georgia Adams, injured in a preseason scrimmage back in at the end of October, has rehabbed and has come back and is contributing once more for the Crimson Storm. She saw action in the final minute at Arkansas Monticello last Saturday, knocking down a three-pointer in the closing moments, and then 6 points in 13 minutes on Thursday out in Shawnee against the Bison. The senior from Mandurah, Australia. Exciting to see her back on the court, and she is a lethal weapon for this Crimson Storm team. Averaged 14.5 points and 5 rebounds per game a year ago, 92% from the free throw line, and 43 made triples on 38% shooting. An automatic increase for this Crimson Storm offense, which at times has had its struggles throughout this 17-0 start. But the floor raised considerably with Adams back in the fold for Southern Nazarene. And just a quick programming note, a little bit of a technical issue with our pregame conversation with head coach Trent May, so we'll be going without this afternoon, but we'll hit on some touch points. One of those being improved three-point shooting for the Crimson Storm over the last several games. In January, they're averaging 7 makes per game and 39% shooting from deep. They're second in the conference in three-point shooting for the season at just over 34%. They make a little more than 6 per game on average, which is good for 6th in the conference. But again, improved shooting in the month of January from deep, and as good as SNU has been on both ends of the court at time, but certainly on the defensive end, the offense, you know, has not given SNU a ton of blowout victories, certainly a lot of double-digit wins, but we haven't seen a ton of 20- and 30-point wins this season for the Crimson Storm. But with improved three-point shooting, we'll see if that takes place over the second half of conference play. This is the beginning of the second go-round through the league for both of these squads, Southeastern and SNU. SNU is on the road for 8 of the first 11, which means obviously there will be 8 home games starting today and through the month of February and into March, capped by a 5 home game and 6 game stretch to end the regular season. So a huge opportunity for SNU to not only be at home, but to keep winning at home, especially on the women's side where they have won 18 straight here at home. Thursday in Shawnee, a 63-46 win over the Bison. It was 42-17 at halftime, a dominating first half performance. SNU struggled in the second half, just 6-23 from the field, shooting under 40% for the game for the first time this season. They did hold the Bison to 26% shooting from the field. Just a overall good win in a road rivalry game. It's always tough to get those wins on the road. Earlier this year, back all the way on November 30th against Southeastern. They won down in Durant 68-62. Not a good first quarter offensively, but we're pretty good on offense the rest of the way. The game was tied at 58 with 4 minutes left, and Lauren Reether had gone out with an injury. She returned and helped key SNU's rally to close out the contest and get out of Durant with a win. Crimson Storm and the Savage Storm have had quite a few close tussles over the years. Four of the last five wins for SNU have been by seven or less, the exception being a 69-45 win at the end of the 21-22 season here in Bethany. Southeastern leads the overall series 22-27. SNU has won the last four and five of the last six, including the last two in Bethany, where SNU holds a 13-12 record against Southeastern. The Savage Storm come into today 6-11 overall, 2-9 in the conference, but they have won their last two after losing 10 consecutive games before snapping the losing streak with wins over Monticello. With the win over East Central on Thursday, a 59-46 win against the Tigers. They outscored the Tigers 37-22 in the second half while holding East Central to 34% shooting, including 4-27 on three-point range. Turnovers have been a major problem for Southeastern this year, nearly 17 a game, but they have been better over the last four games, turning it over just 11 times per game in those contests. They've been close in many games this season. Five of their nine conference losses have been by 6 points or fewer. And the big story here today has been freshman Kinsley Warden out of Tecumseh, Oklahoma. She has started the last four games, averaging 16 points per game, six free throws per game, and 8.5 rebounds per game. So the freshman has given a bit of life to the Savage Storm on both ends of the floor, and that will be a key for SNU today to contain her and keep things in check. Caitlin Kabisky, the junior out of Keller, Texas, she's the engine that makes the Savage Storm go. Outstanding inside, great rebounder, great post player, one of the best in the conference at the four position for head coach Darren Grover in his 22nd season at the helm in Durant. See, and Coach Trent May meeting out on the court right now. Southeastern has started 10 different players over the course of the season thus far. Dealing with several injuries today, as a couple injuries suffered in practice this week, according to Southeastern play-by-play man Jay Lindley. We'll see how Savage Storm are able to play today, and they're dealing with injuries for those who are playing. Just nine players dressed today for the Savage Storm. We'll see if depth becomes a factor for Southeastern here this afternoon at the Sawyer Center. Great crowd on hand. So with a couple minutes before tip-off, and lower bowl pretty full in comparison to typical Saturday afternoons here in Bethany. So word getting out on how good this Crimson Storm women's team is in particular, but it should be a fun game on the men's side as well. I'd expect a lot of offense there, as we always see between the Crimson Storm and the Savage Storm, but a whole new cast of characters on both sides for that matchup, which will be coming up at the conclusion of the women's game this afternoon. We'll step aside for a break. The opening tip, the national anthem, and the starting lineups coming your way. This is SNU Basketball. Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. The starting lineups being introduced. Let's run through those first for the visitors from Southeastern Oklahoma State. First up, number 12, freshman guard Kinsley Warden, 5'9", out of Tecumseh, Oklahoma, averaging 6.5 points and 4.5 rebounds for the season, but 16 points and 8.5 rebounds over her last four in the starting lineup. Number 13, junior guard Ashton Hackler, 6' from Hartshorne, Oklahoma, 7.5 points and 2.5 rebounds per game this season. Number 15, junior forward Caitlin Kabisky, 5'10", from Keller, Texas, 15 points and 6 rebounds per game for Caitlin. Number 22, freshman guard Aaron Dolan, 5'9", from South Coffeyville, Oklahoma, averaging 2.5 points and a rebound per game this season. And rounding out the starters, number 30, junior forward Holly Lindley, 5'10", from Hartshorne, Oklahoma, 9 points, 7 rebounds per game this season. The Savage Storm are coached by Darren Grover in his 19th season at Southeastern Oklahoma State. Assistant coaches are Sammy Joe Cotton Black, Kylie Ragsdale. For your Southern Nazarene Crimson Storm, number 4, senior guard Lauren Reether, 5'5", from Oklahoma City, averaging 18 points, 6 rebounds, and 4 assists per game this season. She also leads the conference in steals with 44. Number 5, senior forward Hannah Giddy, 6'2", from Melbourne, Australia, averaging a double-double this season, 13 points, 10 rebounds, and 6 assists this season. The 6 assists is good for 7th in the nation. She also leads the nation in blocks per game at 3.8 per game and has totaled 65 this season, which is good for 2nd nationally. Number 12, senior guard Emily Monahan, 5'9", from Melbourne, Australia, averaging 12 points and 4 rebounds per game this season. Number 14, sophomore guard Jenna Bay, 5'9", from Shattuck, Oklahoma, averaging 7 points and 3 rebounds per game this season. And number 24, senior guard Abby Giles, 5'7", from Searcy, Arkansas, averaging 9.5 points and 6 rebounds per game this season. The Crimson Storm are coached by Trent May. This is 6th season in Bethany. Assistant coaches are Kayla Tucker, Sydney Salvato, Greg Gilman. Looking around the conference today, everybody in their respective home states this afternoon. Oklahoma Baptist down the road taking on Southwestern Oklahoma State in Weatherford. Arkansas Monticello is at Arkansas Tech. East Central at Northwestern Oklahoma State. Southern Arkansas is at Henderson State. And Ouachita Baptist is at Harding this afternoon. Quick check on the standings on the women's side. SNU obviously number one in the conference at 11-0. Harding a game behind at 10-1. Those two teams will meet in Searcy on February 10th, 2 weeks from today. Go ahead and circle that date and clear your calendars for that one. Northwestern sits two games back of Harding at 8-3. Henderson State is at 7-4. Southwestern 6-5. Arkansas Tech, Oklahoma Baptist, and Ouachita Baptist all at 5-6. Southern Arkansas at 4-7. Monticello and Southeastern at 2-9. And East Central bringing up the rear at 1-10. SNU in their home whites today. Storm in red across the front. White numbers with red trim. Southeastern in their traveling blues. The Southeastern logo on the front, white numbers with yellow trim. Giddy and Kabisky in the middle to jump. It's Giddy who wins the tip. Giles controls to Lauren Reether. SNU moving right to left to start the first quarter. The great crowd on hand, Special Olympics Day here in Bethany. Here's Giles. Entry pass to the free throw line to Giddy. Giddy, loose dribble, got it out to Monahan, left corner. 8 on the shot clock. Monahan got it to Giddy just barely. Giddy with 4 on the shot clock, picks up her dribble to Reether. Pump fake, fires up a 3-pointer at the shot clock buzzer. It hits no iron, and that's a shot clock violation for the Crimson Storm. It's an early turnover for SNU. Here's Dolan across midcourt, guarded by the senior Lauren Reether to Kabisky, right wing. Down low to Warden. Warden, the baseline out to Dolan. She'll try a three. It's no good. Hits the shot clock. Nearly dropped through the basket, but it did hit the shot clock before caroming off. So the ball back to SNU. No points on either team's first possession. Reether across half court, behind the screen from Giles. Now Giddy comes to set a pick. Reether outside Giles. Has an open lane to the basket. Was bumped by Kabisky. Missed the shot. Bay tracked down the offensive rebound, and SNU maintains possession. Here's Monahan. Faking. Steps through in the paint. Missed the shot. Hackler the rebound for the Savage Storm. Here comes Dolan. Cross midcourt, gives to Kabisky right wing. Sets her feet, fires a three. It's online, in and out. Giddy controls the rebound and hands to Reether. 90 seconds gone by, no score between the Storm's Crimson and Savage. Reether into a crowd, up top to Giles, left wing to Bay. To Giddy at the left elbow. Sizing up the defense, outside Reether, top of the circle. Reether diving, gives it to Giddy. A beautiful pick and roll, but Giddy missed everything on the layup attempt, too strong. Here comes Dolan the other way for Southeastern. Outside Hackler. That's Warden. Warden across the paint. Outside Hackler. Drives. Kicks to Warden. 20-foot jumper on the way. Short. Rebound controlled by Bay. And over the back foul is called on Caitlin Kabisky. Not much contact there. Generous call in favor of SNU. So first foul on Kabisky in the first on Southeastern. Kabisky not pleased with that call, as any basketball fan would not be pleased with that one. Giddy outside to Giles, sets her feet, fires a three, hits good. Abby Giles finally breaks the lid on the basket for both teams, and SNU leads 3-0. Giles 5 of 8 from deep over her last three games. Reether guarding the freshman Dolan out top, nearly picked her pocket. Right wing Kabisky. Up top, Hackler. Trier a three to answer and bangs that one in off the back iron. Hackler shooting just 24% from deep. But her three there ties the score at three. Reether got past the freshman Dolan and laid it in for two. 5-3 SNU, 3 minutes gone by in the first quarter. Here's Kabisky backing down on Giddy. Skip pass, Warden. Up top, Kabisky. Kabisky drives on Giddy into the paint, runs into Reether, who came over on the help side. An offensive foul on Caitlin Kabisky, and that's two personal fouls in the first 3 minutes and change on Caitlin Kabisky. She'll have to come out of the ball game. Bree Wiedelman, the junior out of Edmond, transfer out of Northeastern Oklahoma State, into the contest for the first time today. It's Kabisky, 15 points per game and 6 rebounds, finds herself on the bench with two early fouls. Giddy gets it inside to Monahan, and a foul whistled on Southeastern's Ashton Hackler. She's a transfer out of Northeastern State as well. 14 points and 4 rebounds a game last year for the River Hawks. SNU inbounding with 6:41 to go first quarter and a 5-3 lead. Inbounds comes to Giddy, extended left elbow. Sizing up Wiedelman. She'll take her to the basket. Hook shot over. Her head is up and good. 7-3 Southern Nazarene. 6:30 to go first quarter. Here's Dolan to the right baseline. Pulls out from 15. No good on the shot. Giles clears. SNU pushing tempo. Reether driving on the freshman. Entry pass to Giddy at the free throw line. Giddy to Monahan, left wing. Behind the screen from Giddy. Monahan dashing to the basket. Rejected by Wiedelman. And Warden comes up with it for Southeastern. Outside, Holly Lindley. She'll try three. No good. Giles secures another rebound for SNU. Pushing up ahead. Giddy galloping. Tried to go to Bay on the cut, but Hackler got her hand on it and knocked it out of bounds. 5:49 to go first quarter. 7-3 Southern Nazarene. Big development early. Two fouls on Caitlin Kabisky in just over 3 minutes of game action. Here's Giddy, left wing holding, looking for a cutter. Instead gives it to Bay, top of the key. Bay, she'll drive to the basket. It's cut off at the left block. Fades, fires off the glass, and good from Jenna Bay. Bay on the score sheet, 4 out of 5 Crimson Storm players on the score sheet thus far, and a 9-3 lead for the number 4 team in the nation. Here's Wiedelman in front of the SNU bench, left side. Tried to hand to Hackler. Giles cut her off. Now Lindley on the wing. Down low, Hackler. Hackler across the paint, and she is fouled. Foul is going to be on Hannah Giddy, who just missed the block attempt. That's the first on Hannah Giddy. First on the Crimson Storm with 5:10 to go in the first quarter. Into the game for the first time is Amy Alverson. Amy and twin Grace, juniors out of Argyle, Texas. First free throw for Hackler is no good, a rarity. Hackler 91% at the free throw line this season, which is third in the conference. Second one from Hackler is good as it rattles in. 9-4, Crimson Storm with the lead. Reether quickly into the front court. Goes down, shovels to Giddy, left elbow. Reether lets a couple defenders fly by. Now gives it to Giles, left wing Bay, to left elbow Giddy. Giddy finds the cutting Monahan. It's cut off outside. Giles. Giles with 10 on the shot clock, spinning across the paint. Scoop around Hackler's. No good. Wiedelman collects the miss for Southeastern. SNU pounding the paint here in the first quarter. 4:40 to go in the opening frame. Right wing Hackler. Up top, Lindley. Across the paint comes Warden. And an offensive foul on Kinsley Warden. Second offensive foul drawn in the quarter by Lauren Reether. First on Warden, fourth on Southeastern. That'll take us to a timeout. 4:32 to go in the opening quarter. 9-4, Southern Nazarene with the lead. This is SNU basketball.
Character, culture, and Christ have been the motto for Southern Nazarene University for many, many years. When I came as president, I was really curious about those words and really curious to dig into the archives. In fact, a conversation on campus one day with a visitor to our campus who asked that same question, what does character, culture, and Christ mean today? These days, I like to talk about refining character. I think that we're all in process, and in those collegiate years, those years of a university experience, there's a great opportunity to refine character.
Welcome back to the Sawyer Center, 9-4. Southern Nazarene with the early lead, 4:32 to go in the first quarter. Battle between the Storms, Crimson and Savage. And for the Savage Storm, Lauren Beeson, junior out of Lexington, Oklahoma, into the contest for the first time. SNU keeps all five starters out there. Down low, Hannah Giddy. Left block, outside Reether on the left wing. She reposts Giddy. Giddy backing down on Wiedelman across the paint. Soft shot, and the paint is good. Giddy got popped in the cheek there. Second field goal for Hannah Giddy. And SNU leads by 7, 11-4. Right wing Lindley trying to get it to Wiedelman. Now she's in trouble on the right corner. Still looking. Monahan finally takes it away from her. The Crimson Storm senior on the break to the basket. Forces it up and in. Beeson got a hand on it. Monahan remains strong through the contact, laid it in for two, and all five Crimson Storm players on the board, and a 13-4 lead. Here's Hackler backing down Giles. Cross the paint, step through, scoop shot good from Ashton Hackler. Hackler averaging 7.5 points per game this season. Here's Reether all the way to the basket, hit the underside of the backboard with the left-hand layup, and here comes Southeastern the other way. Alverson racing into the front court. Skip pass in the right corner. Wiedelman, open three, step, and is called for a travel. as she stepped into the three-point attempt. And making her Sawyer Center debut this season is Georgia Adams, the senior out of Mandurah, Australia. Played 13 minutes on Thursday at Oklahoma Baptist as Abby Giles takes a seat for SNU. Here's Reitha, right wing, holding. Behind the screen from Giddy. Reitha gets it out to Adams. Adams, entry pass, right block to Giddy. 10 on the shot clock. Giddy backing down, spins away from the double team. Missed the shot. Adams, the offensive rebound, put it back up. It was partially blocked. Loose ball. Hackler comes up with it for Southeastern. Here's Wiedelman, left corner for Southeastern. Sizes up Giddy, fires a three, and rips the cords. Bree Wiedelman, just 6 of 14 from deep this season, but her seventh triple of the year makes it 13-9 in favor of SNU. 2:20 to go in the first quarter. Monahan up top to Bay, to Giddy, right wing, looking for a cutter. It's not there. Now finds Adams. Adams, guarded by Hackler. To Giddy at the free throw line. Oh, nice give and go. Adams, oh, reverse layup is good. That was pretty, the Aussie connection. Here's Beeson, closed out nicely. Here's Wiedelman now, right wing. Picks up her dribble, looking for help. Looking, still looking. Finally gets it to Hackler, top of the key. Hackler drives on Adams, kicks it left wing to Alverson. Now Hackler, baseline, forced it up, missed the shot. Good defense by Adams, a rebound from Hannah Giddy. Reitha along the far sideline. Darren Grover incensed there wasn't a foul called there. Reitha, entry to Giddy at the right elbow. Up top, Adams. Adams driving to the basket, steps through contact, shovels to Giddy, but traveled before she was able to get the pass away. Trent May disagreeing with the call. Carly Gassaway in for SNU. Jenna Bay takes a seat. Grace Alverson in for Hackler for Southeastern. 15-9, Southern Nazarene leads. 1:18 to go first quarter. Here's Warden. Got by Monahan and an easy deuce there. Monahan closed out a little too high. Warden took the baseline and the easy two. Her first bucket of the game, 15-11, Southern Nazarene leads. Giddy hands to Monahan, who gives it back to Giddy, right of the paint. Giddy spins away from Wiedelman, too strong with the shot. Adams, the offensive rebound, puts it back up and in. Georgia Adams playing like she never left. 4 points in the quarter, 17-11, under a minute to go in the period. Here's Grace Alverson, drives. Behind the back dribble, freezer from Gassaway. Now they whip it around to Amy Alverson in the left corner. Back up top, Warden to Grace Alverson. Here's Wiedelman, left wing. Grace Alverson tries a three from the right wing and rips the cords. 23 seconds to go in the period. 17-14 SNU. Southeastern, their third triple of the quarter in six attempts. They are fifth in the league in three-point shooting at 33%. Reitha behind the Giddy pick, finds a gap all the way to the basket. Left-hand layup is no good. Warden has the rebound for Southeastern. 4 seconds. Warden at half court fires a heave. It's no good, and that's how the first quarter comes to a close. 17-14, Southern Nazarene with the lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State. We'll take a timeout and be back for more. This is SNU Basketball.
The legacy began in 1973. That was the year NCAA Division II was born. And since the very first day, our division has shaped generations of student-athletes with a true sense of academics, athletics, and community. That is 5 decades of graduations, championships, teamwork, and personal development. 50 years of shaping student-athletes into world-class leaders. NCAA Division II. Our division, our legacy.
Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. 17-14, SNU leads Southeastern Oklahoma State. Luke McConnell with you as we begin the second half of Great American Conference play. Same five out there for both squads, or excuse me, for SNU out of the timeout. Aaron Dolan back in for Amy Alverson for Southeastern. Here's Wiedelman, right corner for Southeastern. Hands to Alverson, finds Warden across the paint, got underneath Monahan and laid it in for two. Warden, the freshman, out of Tecumseh, 4 points so far, and SNU's lead is 1-17-16. Reether, outside Adams, sets her feet, shot partially blocked, but a foul is called on Warden. A little too aggressive in the closeout, and that's now two on Kinsley Warden. Looked like Warden got a lot of ball there, but the official, who was significantly closer than me, disagreed. So Georgia Adams going to the line for three free throws, her first free throw attempts of the season, and 92% at the free throw line a year ago. She knocks down the first. Abby Giles and Ashton Hackler at the scores table set to check in after this second free throw for Adams. Adams goes 2-for-2 thus far. Third one on the way from Georgia is good. Monahan checks out. Abby Giles back in. Warden sits down. So both Warden and Kibiski, easily the two best offensive options for Southeastern over the last few games in particular, out with two personal fouls each. 9:30 to go. First half, 20-16 SNU. Here's Alverson. Down low to Wiedelman. Wiedelman got around Giddy, who rejected the shot, but a foul is called, and that's now two fouls on Hannah Giddy. She has the only two fouls for the Crimson Storm in the first half. Wiedelman's first free throw rattles in. Wiedelman, 70% at the line this season. Shannon Burton at the scores table set to check in for SNU. Second free throw on the way from Wiedelman is good. Giddy heads to the bench with two personal fouls, 4 points, three rebounds, two assists. So foul trouble amongst both teams' stars here in the early going, 20-18. SNU with the lead. Reether behind the back dribble gives it to Giles, top of the key. Giles looking for help, gets it into Burton. Burton in the paint, backing down Wiedelman. Step through move, left-hand shot, off the glass and good. A nice move by Shannon Burton. Her first point since December 9th. That pushes the lead back to four. Here's Dolan trying to get free of Reether. Hackler has it now out on the right wing. Hackler into the paint. Skip pass out to Beeson, left wing. Beeson looking for help. Now back to Hackler on the wing. Hackler. And Reether comes in, picks her pocket. Up ahead, Gassaway. Gassaway with Alverson challenging. Gassaway missed the shot. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Beeson. It'll stay with SNU at 24 on the shot clock. Holly Lindley back in for Southeastern. Inbounds comes to Adams. Adams around to the right side of the paint. Steps through. Missed the shot. A lot of contact there. No call. Here comes Dolan for Southeastern. Dolan working on Abby Giles. Outside Alverson. Now Hackler left of the paint. Guarded by Burton. Hackler looking. Looking. Outside Dolan on the wing. 12 on the shot clock. Dolan, entry pass to Hackler at the GAC logo. Got around Burton, forced it up, missed the shot. Adams had the rebound, knocked away from her. No call. And here comes Reether. Galloping into the paint. Lost the ball. Lot of contact there, no call. And here comes Southeastern the other way. Lindley outside to Beeson. Beeson to the right block. Throws it up, crawls over the rim, no good. Gassaway clears. 22-18, Southern Nazarene with the lead. 7:30 to go first half. A lot of contact being let go in the second quarter. That contact was not let go as Aaron Dolan with a forearm shiver to Reether on the drive. First foul on Dolan. Second on the Savage Storm in the quarter. George Adams checks out, leading the team with 7 points, 2 rebounds. Jenna Bay back in with 7:18 to go in the quarter. 22-18 SNU. Reether inbounding. Inbounds up top to Giles. Giles. Right wing to Gasway. Back up top, Giles. Right elbow to Burton. Burton to Giles. Giles hides behind the screen. Fires another three. It's no good. Lindley has the rebound for Southeastern. Dolan up ahead to Beeson on the right wing. Outside, Lindley. Over to Hackler. Hackler guarded by Burton. Backdoor cut. Lindley got free of Giles. Pass took her across the paint too far. Lindley missed the shot short. Burton has the rebound for SNU. Burton cross half court. Gives it to Reether. Reether guarded by the freshman Dolan. Barks out the signals. 20 on the shot clock. Reether drives right. Kicks it out. Gasaway. Gasaway got by Alverson. Stops. Pulls up. And a travel is called on Gasaway. Looked like she kept the pivot foot still. Fourth turnover for SNU. Caitlin Kabisky back into the contest for Beeson. Hannah Duncan in for the first time today for Carly Gasaway. 22-18 SNU lead, 6:24 to go first half. Here's Kabisky right wing. Left wing to Lindley. Lindley drives by Giles to the block. Force it up through contact. No good. No call. Bay has the rebound for SNU. Reether, long lead pass ahead for Duncan. Duncan stops at the left block to Giles. They swing it around. Bay open, top of the key for three. It's off, no good. And an over-the-back foul is the call on Shannon Burton, battling with Kabisky for the rebound. First on Burton, second on the Crimson Storm. And SNU now scoreless over 3 minutes in the second quarter. 6:05 to go in the period, 22-18. SNU now 1 of 5 from the field. Southeastern also 1 of 5 from the field in the quarter. Dolan to Kabisky. Kabisky pulls up from the right elbow and drains it over Burton. 22-20, 5:45 to go second quarter. Reether gives to Burton, left elbow. Hands back to Reether. Reether just 2 points today. Reether at the foul circle. 15 on the shot clock, gives it back to Burton, left of the paint. Burton working on Kabisky, low dribble, lost the ball, loose. Lindley and Burton are tied up. Stays with SNU with 8 on the shot clock. .526 to go in the quarter. Amy Alverson back in for Dolan. Beeson will come back in for Grace Alverson. Reether inbounding for SNU, left baseline. Gets it into Giles, outside to Bay. 5 on the shot clock. Bay hounded by Kabisky. Bay stops, fades, fires, air ball. And that's another turnover for SNU. Their second shot clock violation of the half. Southeastern with an opportunity to tie or take the lead on this possession. 5:15 to go first half. Alverson pestered by Reether up top. Right wing to Kabisky. Kabisky. Up top, Alverson. Back up top, Kabisky now. Kabisky at the left elbow. Gets it out to Alverson. Top of the key, Beeson. 8 on the shot clock. Beeson pulls up from 18. It's no good. Giles another rebound. Her third. Giles taking it all the way into the paint. Stops. Left-hand shot's no good. Burton knocks that away from Southeastern out of play. And that brings us to a timeout on the court. 22-20, SNU with the lead, but struggling from the field here in the second quarter. Today at halftime, we'll have the Special Olympics game here at the Sawyer Center. Special Olympics provides year-round sports training and athletic competition in a variety of Olympic-type sports for children and adults with intellectual disabilities, giving them continuing opportunities to develop physical fitness, demonstrate courage, experience joy, and participate in a sharing of gifts, skills, and friendship with their families, other Special Olympics athletes, and the community. Today, Special Olympics Oklahoma benefits 12,100 athletes and is supported by over 13,000 volunteer coaches and thousands of sponsors, donors, and volunteers conducting more than 175 sports competitions and training clinics every year. So we'll have that for you at halftime. A couple of the SNU men's basketball program will be helping out with that game. It should be a lot of fun, and we'll have that for you at halftime here. With 4:42 to go in the second quarter, SNU 1 of 6 from the field in the second quarter. Southeastern 2 of 7, combined 11 points in the period. SNU shooting 36% for the game, the Savage Storm 39%. Southeastern buoyed by a 3 of 6 showing from deep in that opening frame. SNU keeps the same five on the floor. Kinsley Warden back in for Southeastern out of the timeout. She's got it at the foul circle. Into the paint. Gets it to Kibiski on the baseline. Kibiski is fouled by Giles as she was reaching in trying to tie up Kibiski. The foul on Giles is her first and the third team foul on SNU in the period. Fresh 20 for the Savage Storm is Emily Monahan coming back in for Hannah Duncan. Lindley, inbounding for Southeastern, looking, still looking, fires it into Hackler. It's knocked away, and it goes out of bounds. It will be Southeastern basketball up at the scorer's table. Beeson checks back in for Warden. Beeson, looking, looking, fires it to Alverson, but it was wide of her, intercepted by Bay. Fourth turnover of the half for Southeastern. Giles open, right wing three is no good. Rebound loose. Lindley got it and smartly put it on the floor just in time before a travel. Here's Alverson for Southeastern to Kibiski. Right baseline, Beeson working on Monahan. Beeson trying to step through. Monahan having none of it. Outside Kibiski, got past Burton, bullies her way in. Burton got a piece of it, and Giles comes up with a loose ball. Here's Reether, shovels to Burton. Burton into the paint, steps around Kibiski, just missed the left-hand layup. Nice move there by Burton, but SNU unable to convert. And the scoring drought, over 5 minutes now for SNU. Beeson, top of the key, gives to Kibiski. Kibiski, thinking about it, pulls up from the foul circle, left it short. Giles, another rebound, her fifth. Reether across half court. Slows it down, calls out the signals. Behind the screen from Burton, heads left. Reether finds a hole, kicks it left corner. Monahan, open three, high arcing three. Hits good. Emily Monahan rattles in the first triple of the quarter for SNU. It snaps a nearly 6 minute scoreless drought. And SNU leads 25-20. Here's Lindley up top, guarded by Bay. Heads right to the wing. Now she drives to the basket. Bay with a bump. No call. Lindley pivoting on the baseline outside Kibiski in the corner. Kibiski into the paint around Burton. Forced it up. She was fouled. And two shots coming for Caitlin Kibiski. Foul on Burton is her second personal foul. Fourth on SNU in the period with 2:38 to go before halftime. Burton checks out. Georgia Adams back in for SNU. So a small lineup out there for SNU with Adams effectively the five at 5'10". Kibiski, an excellent free throw shooter, knocks in the first. 83%, makes 12 straight. Makes at the free throw line for the junior from Keller. Shot 181 free throws a season ago. She goes 2 for 2. 25-22. Southern Nazarene with the lead, 2:35 to go before halftime. Here's Jenna Bay, left wing for the Crimson Storm. Up top to Adams, right wing to Reether. Reether, up top Monahan, fires it left baseline to Bay, outside to Adams. Sets her feet, fires a three. It's good! Georgia Adams, her first triple of the game. She's now 4 of 5 in 3 games since returning from injury. And the SNU lead is 6, 28-22. Nice defense by Monahan. Warden trying to get free. Reether ripped it away from her. Reether with Alverson. Reether takes it in. She's fouled. And Lauren Reether going to the line for 2 free throws. Could have tagged Warden for a hook against Emily Monahan. That wasn't going to happen. But Lauren Reether taking it right at Amy Alverson. And Reether heading to the line for 2 free throws. 43 of 50 from the charity stripe in January. Knocks down the first. 81% for the season. Second one's up and good. SNU lead balloons to 8. And it is an 8-2 run for the Crimson Storm. 2 minutes to go, first half. 30-22, Southern Nazarene. Here's Alverson, picks up her dribble, gives it to Kabisky up top, guarded by Adams. Kabisky drives on Adams, is triple teamed. They swing it around. Hackler, open three, is no good. And Bay gets the rebound. Adams, a nice box out on Kabisky. Here's Adams with it, right wing on the pass from Reether. Looking. Doesn't get the look she wants. Now Reether back to Adams, right wing. Open three on the way. That one's short. And that one caroms off the rim out of bounds. Wiedemann back in for the Savage Storms. Kabisky takes a seat with those 2 personal fouls. Warden also in there right now with 2 personal fouls for Southeastern. Hannah Giddy's been on the bench for the majority of the second quarter with 2 personal fouls for SNU, but they still lead by 8 with 1:10 to go in the quarter. Here's Wiedemann, guarded by Adams. Wiedemann picks up her dribble, gives it to Hackler. Just inside the arc on the right side, working against Abby Giles. Across the paint, outside Lindley. Thought about a deep three. Instead, she'll drive. Floater from the GSC logo is no good, but a blocking foul is called on Abby Giles. That's number 2 on Abby with 56 seconds to go in the quarter. Holly Lindley to the line for 2 free throws, 75% foul shooter this season. Warden checks in, or checks out, rather, with those 2 fouls. Lauren Beeson back in. So 2 free throws for Lindley. First one is good, making her 22 of 26 over the last 7 games, including this afternoon. Second one from Lindley, no good. Adams corrals the rebound, shovels ahead to Reether. Reether galloping, crosses over on Lindley, to the basket, too strong, and a late whistle. This is the right whistle. Darren Grover doesn't like it, but it is the right call. It was just a little late. Reether got clipped by Lindley going to the basket. Giles checks out. Hannah Duncan back in for SNU, and Lauren Reether back at the line for 2 free throws. Reether just 1 for 4 from the field today. It does have 4 points, 2 assists, and 2 steals. First free throw is no good. It snaps a string of 17 consecutive makes over 4 games. Second one from Reether, also no good. And a timeout called by Darren Grover with 51 seconds left in the half. 30-23, Southern Nazarene with the lead. SNU not shooting particularly well. 37% from the field and 3 of 11 here in the second quarter. They are helped by the fact that Southeastern has been worse. 2 of 10 in the quarter for Southeastern and 33% for the game. Georgia Adams, 10 points in 9 minutes. for SNU, her first game at the Sawyer Center this year after missing the first 15. After sustaining an injury in a preseason scrimmage. It's just good to see her back on the court in this, her senior year in Bethany. So 51 seconds left for Southeastern. Lindley gets it into Amy Alverson, who races into the front court. Entry pass to Hackler, left of the paint, working on Duncan. SNU reaching. Hackler picked up her dribble. Now Beeson has it. Step through on Bay. Scoop layup is good with 33 seconds to go. Lauren Beeson on the board with her third field goal attempt, and it's 30-25. SNU with the lead. Here's Adams at the right elbow. Gives to Duncan. Back to Adams. Adams picks up her dribble. Gets it to Bay. To Reether, left wing. 15 on the shot clock. Plenty of time. Here's Reether. Back to Adams. Adams finds a lane, drives, and an offensive foul is the call on Georgia Adams as Holly Lindley stepped over and took the charge. First foul on Georgia Adams today with 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Lindley gets it into Alverson. It goes out of bounds. Reether trying to advocate for an SNU ball, but stays with Southeastern. Lindley still working to get it in. SNU double teaming. Entry pass comes to Beeson. Beeson guarded by Bay. Up ahead, Lindley across half court. Lindley outside Alverson. Alverson fires a three. It's no good. And that's how the first half comes to an end here at the Sawyer Center. 30-25. Southern Nazarene with the lead after 20 minutes of play. Not a particularly pretty half either way for the Storms, Crimson and Savage. But SNU will take the 5-point lead into the halftime locker room. We'll step aside for a quick break. We'll come back with SNU men's head coach B.J. Foster. We'll also have our Special Olympics basketball game coming up in just a few moments. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. This is SNU basketball. And welcome back to the Sawyer Center. SNU leading Southeastern Oklahoma State 30-25 at halftime. We're joined now by SNU men's head coach B.J. Foster. The Crimson Storm and Savage Storm tangling for the second time this year on the other side of the women's game. And B.J., going back to Thursday night, a great road win over your arch rival Oklahoma Baptist. I guess it's now your arch rival, yeah. Oklahoma Baptist, but a really nice, gritty road win for your guys.
Yeah, I thought we played pretty good throughout the course of the game. I thought we were really, really solid. Obviously, would have liked to have finished it off a little easier, but any road win we are finding out in this league is a good win.
Absolutely. Giannis Visser, a great game, 24 points and 11 rebounds. Seemed like he really took advantage of the matchup inside there.
Yeah, he did. He had a terrific game, probably the best game he's had since he's been here. But, you know, I was more pleased with how dialed in he was on the defensive side. We tried a little different ball screen coverage where he was in drop position, and we hadn't done that this year. And he did a terrific job for a short amount of prep time on working on it, and he just seemed really engaged. And usually when guys are engaged on that side of the ball, good things happen on the offensive side of the ball, and that was a good example of that.
One thing you guys have made an adjustment of over – you know, this kind of in 2024, you've had Ben Baker McCann handling the ball and played Benno a little bit more off the ball. What has that done for the flow of your offense?
Yeah, you know, we're still figuring guys out, and you know, we needed to make a adjustment to tweak to see if we could get Benno in some different areas on the floor, see if we could run the offense a little bit better. But you know, both of those guys aren't necessarily point guards; they're combo guards, and so it's so they each kind of get an opportunity. They'll both play it today because we're going against a pressing team, and you know, I think it's nice to have the option to kind of go with either one of them.
You're halfway through the Great American Conference season. What are your thoughts on the first 11?
You know, it's a good league. I mean, really, really solid teams across the board. I think there's not much drop off, and it's pretty even. I mean, I think anybody can win on any given night. Each team has some strengths. Each team has some weaknesses, and you know, I've really enjoyed getting to know some of the coaches in the conference, and you know, each night poses a different challenge, and so it's just good to kind of know people's systems, know what they're about, and you know, and hopefully we can be stronger along the way.
Second time facing Southeastern here this afternoon, fell to them down in Durant. What do you take away from that first matchup that you'd like to do a little differently today?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot we learned from that game. They're a difficult matchup. I mean, I think they probably are the hardest team in the conference to match up with. You know, teams that play with five out versus a traditional big inside have given us problems this season. You know, they're pressing the whole game, running, jumping the whole game, and they shoot the ball across the board. Every one of them shoots the three ball. So probably the hardest game that we have in terms of preparation, in terms of us having to just not match up particularly well. And so they're good. You know, the point guard, I don't know how he got out of Bethany, but a local kid here, and he's a terrific player. But so he poses some threats to us, and then obviously everybody shooting the ball. So good team, good program, very tough matchup. But at least we got him at home this time.
Your 3-point defense has been excellent over the course of the year, just allowing 30% from deep and just 7 of 32 the last two games. Are you excited to put that to the test today against a really good shooting team?
Well, I don't know if exciting is the right word for that, but you know, we know what we have to do to slow them down and to get the win. And you know, it's there is a strategy to it. There is you got to go out and you got to execute it. You got to believe in it, and if you can do that, you give yourself an opportunity to win the game. And so, obviously, slowing down the three ball and transition and making them play half court and really contesting those shots is going to be a huge part of that.
Got the Special Olympics game going on right now. A couple of your freshmen out there helping out. Seems like moments like these are, you know, kind of the backbone of SNU as a school and as a program.
It's fantastic. I mean, we got our team down there as well cheering. I mean, this is fun stuff right here. So it's real proud of our guys. They really get involved in things, and this is just a fun atmosphere right here.
Absolutely. Well, BJ, thanks for your time. As always, look forward to seeing your guys against the Savage Storm coming up shortly.
All right, thanks.
That's SNU men's head coach B.J. Foster. The festivities continue down on the court. Let's get you the lineups out there. Right now for the SNU men's program, you got freshman Xander Baker and a freshman Luca Cawthorn-Briani. And the guys out on the court tearing it up right now. It's Craig Baker with the three-pointer. You got Cam Dawson out there. Quayshawn Moses also out there. These are all folks that participate in Special Olympics Oklahoma. You got Caden Haynes out there. And Daniel Nabjiji out there as well. So just a lot of fun here this afternoon and getting to see these guys play and just go at each other. And some quality basketball being played out there right now as well. So We'll keep the camera going there. We'll take a step aside audio-wise for a quick break and come back, break down the first half, get scores from around the league, and get you ready for the second half of action. Again, at the break, 30-25, SNU with the lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State. We'll be back with more. This is SNU Basketball. Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. Number four team in the land, Southern Nazarene leading Southeastern Oklahoma State 30-25 at halftime. Luke McConnell here with you in the Sawyer Center. Just had a tremendous Special Olympics game here at Bobby Martin Court, and tons of fun, crowd really into it. So grateful to be a part of that and to see that all transpire. Both teams back, making their way back on the court for the second half of action. Crimson Storm shot just 37% from the field in the first half, 3 of 8 from three-point range and 5 of 7 at the free throw line. Southeastern, Oklahoma State, 35% in the first half. 3 of 8 from deep, 6 of 8 from the free throw line. SNU, a 19-14 edge on the glass, 4-0 on the offensive glass, but just a 2-0 edge in second chance points. SNU 14-8 points in the paint, 4 points off 5 Southeastern turnovers, just 2 points for Southeastern off 6 SNU turnovers. No fast break points for SNU in the first half, 2 for Southeastern. Individually for the Crimson Storm, 10 points for Georgia Adams leading the way, 3 of 6 from the field, 3 of 3 at the foul line with 3 rebounds. Strong first half back at home for the senior from Australia. Emily Monahan, 5 points. 4 points each for Hannah Giddy and Lauren Reether. Giddy sat the final 9 minutes of the first half with 2 personal fouls. Abby Giles with 3. Jenna Bay with 2. And Shannon Burton with 2. And rounds out the scoring for the Crimson Storm. For Southeastern, 6 points for Ashton Hackler. 4 for Kinsley Warden. 4 for Caitlin Kabisky. Picked up 2 personal fouls in the first 3 minutes and change of the first quarter, and had sat for the remainder of the period and came back in the second quarter, eventually played 8 minutes and a half. No points for Aaron Dolan, 1 point for Holly Lindley, 2 for Lauren Beeson, 5 for Bree Wiedelman off the bench, and 3 off the bench for Grace Alverson. SNU's been a third quarter team for much of the year. They'll need to be a third quarter team today in order to get things going and stave off the Savage Storm, who always play SNU tough. Talking to Trent May yesterday before today's game, always a tough matchup between these two. Can never get a big one over Darren Grover's team. Quick check on scores from around the league. Arkansas Tech doubling up Arkansas Monticello at halftime, 54-27. Arkansas Tech all over the Blossoms in that one. Halftime up in Alva, 31-26. The Rangers leading East Central at halftime. Unexpectedly close contest, as Northwestern needed a 9-0 run over the last 4 minutes to even have a halftime lead. Late third quarter out in Weatherford between Southwestern and Oklahoma Baptist. It's the Bulldogs 43 and Oklahoma Baptist 32. Henderson State, third quarter action, 44-25 over Southern Arkansas. And Ouachita Baptist at Harding, that is a 5:30, 7:30 doubleheader this evening. Starting lineups back on the court for both squads. Lindley gets it in to Hackler to start things for Southeastern. Moving right to left in the second half, Dolan frees herself of Reether. Warden frees herself of Monahan. Missed the shot badly, and Warden goes over the back of Hannah Giddy right off the bat, picking up her third personal foul 12 seconds into the quarter. So that's 3 on Warden. Again, 2 on Giddy and 2 on Kabisky. Abby Giles also out there with 2 personal fouls for SNU. She's got it now, top of the key. Entry pass to Giddy. Backing down on Kabisky. Giddy, skip past Monahan, right wing. Drives on Warden. Stops, pulls up from 12. Off the back iron. No good. Lindley clears the glass for Southeastern. Good look from Monahan. Couldn't get it to fall. Here's Dolan, right wing, to Hackler. Pass goes through her hands, but she corrals it in the corner. Finds Dolan on the cut, who pulls up and hits from the right block off glass. 30-27, SNU with the lead. They've led by as many as 9. Southeastern has scored the last 5 points in the contest. Here's Giddy. Gets around Kabisky. Left-hand layup is good. Monahan did a nice job coming across the paint. Took a lot of Southeastern players with her, and that allowed Giddy to dive to the basket and lay it in for 2. She's got 6. Pass knocked away into the backcourt. Dolan tracks it down with 19 on the shot clock. Dolan, very quick with the handles. And a foul inside on the Crimson Storm. It's going on Monahan. Didn't see what was happening. It was well away from the play. First on Emily. First team foul on the Crimson Storm in the quarter. 8:37 to go second quarter, 32-27 SNU. Orton lobs into Kabisky, left baseline. Now into the paint goes Kabisky, knocked away from her by Reether, and Giles has it for the Crimson Storm. Reether, left elbow, Hannah Giddy. Monahan on the cut's not there. Here's Reether behind the screen from Giddy, heads left, gives it to Bay, top of the key. Bay trying to post up Giddy, has it right of the paint. Giddy backing down, double teams comes, fires it to Giles. Absorbs some contact from Hackler and put it in for two. Great find from Gritty. Great cut by Abby Giles. She's got five in the lead, back to seven for SNU. Dolan steps into a three, in and out. Rebound comes down to Giddy, who hands to Reether. Warden nearly got there first. SNU able to corral it in time. 7:48 to go, third quarter. SNU leading by seven. Giddy working on Kabisky. Double team comes. Pass deflected, stolen by Warden. Looking for Reether. Here's Dolan. Again, some nice handles from the freshman. Up top, Kabisky. Left wing to Lindley. Lindley sizing up Jenna Bay. Finds an alley, drives to the left block. Cut off by Bay. Bay got elbowed in the face on the step through. She goes down. Lindley lays it in for two, and Bay is down holding her face. Timeout on the court with 7:17 to go. One official explaining, I believe, to SNU players why that's not an offensive foul. Two other officials are discussing and are going to go to the monitor to look at it, I believe. Bay in some considerable pain. It looks like she's tell if she's holding her eye more than her nose. But Lindley on the step through. Elbow straight to the face. Jenna Bay. So Georgia Adams is going to check in for Bay. We'll see if there's anything that results from the video review. Situations are always tough to officiate. You have the cylinder rule that the defender can't violate as far as stepping into the offensive player's space, but also anything elbow-wise can be considered a flagrant foul as well. We'll see what the officials determine. SNU leads by five, then led by five at halftime. Now third official steps in to take a peek. Bay down on the training table over on the left side of the court behind the Southeastern bench and fans. Holding a towel over her face. I think, I don't want to speculate, I think shock more than anything. Only with a quick whip through on this pivot. An elbow high to the face. Never going to feel good regardless of the intentionality. The officials huddling. We'll see if they deem it excessive contact. First of eight home games in the second half of the season for the Crimson Storm. They close the regular season with five home games and six, though one road trip there to Alva, and then one road trip to Arkansas for Arkansas Tech and Harding. Now the official huddling with the head coaches to explain the situation. Both coaches seem calm and understanding, and there will be no foul on Holly Lindley. Jenna Bay has gone back to the training room, so Georgia Adams in. Has already played 10 minutes today, played 13 on Thursday at Oklahoma Baptist, and now will be counted on in an extended variety. Reether cut off, gets it out to Monahan, left wing. Southeastern flying a double every time SNU comes into the paint. Reether looks on the roll. Nope. Monahan, three-pointer from in front of her bench. That's short. Kibiski has the rebound. Up ahead, Warden. Under 7 minutes to go, third quarter. Warden picks up her dribble, gives to Kibiski. Left wing, Lindley. Lindley drives, runs over Monahan, and a blocking foul is called on Emily Monahan, who is just a smidge late coming across. Second on Emily, second team foul on SNU, and with 6:40 in the third quarter, Holly Lindley will shoot two free throws. Lindley 1-for-2 at the line today, 3 points, 5 rebounds. First one rims out, no good. Official waiting on Reether to tie her shoe over in front of Coach Trent May. Second one from Lindley is on the way and good. 4-point lead again for SNU, 34-30. 6:40 to go, third quarter. Reether bumped up top, no call. Gives it to Giddy at the foul line. Kicks it out. Monahan tries a corner three. That one's no good. Kibiski up high for the rebound. Here come the Savage Storm quickly. Warden driving to the left block. Outside Kibiski sets her feet, fires a three. That's short all the way. Reether, the rebound for SNU. Left corner, Monahan. Third time the charm. It is not. As she misses that one once more, Warden clears the glass for the Savage Storm. Here comes Dolan. Quickly flies by Reether to the left block. Gets it outside. Hackler. Hackler to Kibiski up top. Now Warden at the foul circle. Outside Lindley thought about a deep three. Instead, will drive on Adams to the right block, and she puts it in for two. 34-32. Crimson Storm, the run for Southeastern, is 5-0. And SNU, another two-plus minute scoring drought. 5:28 to go in the third quarter. Giddy working on Kibiski. Spins. Looks for help. Monahan has it. Monahan stops. Fires it to Giddy. Left block. Got around Hackler. Reverse layup. Oh, it's up and good. What a move from Hannah Giddy. That was really pretty from the Aussie. 36-32. 5 minutes to go, third quarter. Lindley behind the back dribble trying to get free of Adams. Looking for help. Needs help. Gets it to Warden. Warden. Double team, pulls up from 15, hit the side of the backboard. Rebound caroms to Giddy. Now up ahead, Monahan, 1-on-3. She'll circle the wagons back out up top. Here's Adams, right wing. Is to Giddy, right elbow. Giddy, bounce pass to Reether. Jump stop and a foul on Warden, and that is number 4 on Kinsley Warden. With 4:39 to go in the third quarter. And that takes us to our media timeout. 36-32, SNU with the lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State. We'll be back with more. This is SNU Basketball.
My favorite things about SNU was the relationships I was able to have with people, with professors, with friends.
One thing that was purposely different about SNU was the integration of faith into the academics. I feel like I learned so much from that that helped prepare me for life after college, to be a husband and someday to be a father. It was a really, really transformational time in my life.
My degree could have come from anywhere, but my relationships with people, I know I would not have gotten anywhere else. Go to snu.edu to apply or to schedule a visit.
36-32, Southern Nazarene leads Southeastern Oklahoma State. 4:39 to go in the third quarter. SNU in a tussle once again with their brethren from down in Durant. Lauren Reether at the line for two free throws after the fourth foul on Kinsley Warden, the freshman out of Tecumseh. Reether rattles in the first. She has five today. Second one on the way is perfect. So SNU back up six, 38-32. Carly Gassaway in for Georgia Adams. Jenna Bay making her way back toward the bench for SNU after taking an elbow to the face. Kibiski, it's a long two. It's very long on the shot. Monahan out and running. Three on three break. Monahan, nice bounce pass to Gassaway. And she lays it in through contact. What a feed from Monahan. And Gassaway, a beautiful finish through contact. Alverson looking for the basketball. It's deflected off of Reether, off of Alverson. SNU a little helter-skelter on the fast break coverage. Gassaway fell down. Alverson was wide open. But Reether with a huge deflection to get possession for SNU. 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Giddy holding right elbow for SNU. Here's Reether. Run off the line by Dolan. Now Reether kicks it right corner. Gassaway open three on the way. It's good. Carly Gassaway. Her second bucket in as many possessions. The 5-0 Gassaway burst gives SNU their biggest lead of the afternoon, 43-32. Danger time for the Savage Storm. Here's Alverson up top. Left wing Hackler. Baseline left. Lindley backing down on Monahan. Cut off. Picks up her dribble, bounces it into the middle of the paint, looking for Hackler, but it's knocked out of bounds by SNU with 11 on the shot clock. 3:32 to go, third quarter. This one has turned quite quickly, a 9-0 burst for SNU in the last 2 minutes. Lindley inbounds to Dolan, left wing, flings it across to Kibiski. Kibiski across the paint, missed the shot, but a foul on Hannah Giddy will be her third personal foul. With 3:27 to go in the third. Kibiski's first free throw on the way and good. Kibiski, 5 points now. 1 of 5 from the field today. Just a single rebound. SNU's kept her in check for the most part. Second one, up and good. 43-34 SNU, 3:27 to go, third quarter. That snaps a 9-0 run for SNU. Crimson Storm shooting 5 of 9 from the field in the third quarter. Jenna Bay back on the bench. Here's Gassaway, left wing, to Giddy at the foul line. Giddy given some space by Kibiski. Now backing. Hackler came over, knocked it away from her. Giddy trying to tie her up. And a foul is going to be called on Hannah Giddy. So Hannah Giddy now with four personal fouls is going to have to check out with 3:04 to go in the third quarter. Lindley inbounds to Kibiski. So Georgia Adams being asked to do a lot today. And Giddy, I think, just found out that that was a foul on her. She is in shock over on the bench. Here's Dolan across the paint, keeping that forearm up, throws it in to the basket off of Reether. No good. Here's Gassaway, left wing to Adams, bumped by Kibiski, no call. Up top, Giles. Outside Adams. Adams drives by Kibiski all the way to the basket. Too strong. Missed it. Got it back. Put it back up. No good. Loose ball. Monahan has it. Out to Gassaway. Wide open left wing for three. In and out. And Alverson has the rebound. Here come the Savage Storm. Dolan to Alverson. Right wing. Alverson pivoting on Gassaway. Hackler. Has it right baseline, working on Giles. Reether reached in, knocked it away. Adams tipped it to Reether. Up ahead, Monahan on the break. Puts it up and lays it in for two. What a tip by Adams over to Reether. The long lead pass to Monahan. That was picture perfect. Dolan drives, right baseline, pulls up, left it short. Reether the rebound. Her fourth of the afternoon. 45-34. Reether to the basket. Missed the layup. Adams was pushed on the rebound. No call. 1:35 to go. SNU leads by 11. Here's Lindley, right wing. Down low to Alverson. Alverson fades on Gassaway, and a foul is called on Gassaway. The official indicating a push on Gassaway. Alverson hit the shot. It counts, and she'll go to the line for one. The first on Gassaway is the fifth team foul on the Crimson Storm in the quarter. Alverson was fading away. The official indicated a push. Not sure how that was even possible. Alverson completes a three-point play to make it an eight-point lead for SNU, 45-37. Beeson, Grace Alverson, and Wiedelman into the basket. Lauren Reether all the way to the basket. Gets knocked into the stanchion. No call. She scores anyway. 47-37, SNU, 1:10 to go. And now Reether picks Alverson's pocket. Reether. Three on one to Adams. Layup, good. You can tell the Crimson Storm starting to get a little mad. Woe to Southeastern. Beeson, step through on Monahan. Wild shot, no good. Reether has it. Reether takes her time across half court. And an opportunity here for SNU to step on the throat with 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. Reether working up top, kicks it out, right corner Monahan, three on the way, short. Grace Alverson, the rebound, gives it up to Sister Amy. Cross half court, Southeastern can hold for the final shot. Between the rings with 12. Here goes Amy Alverson, driving. Floater over Adams, too strong. Loose ball, Reether tips it away. Monahan has it with one. Fires it up, no good. And that's how the third quarter ends. SNU seizing control here in the third period. They'll take a 12-point lead into the final stanza. 49-37, the Crimson Storm with the lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State. We'll take a break and come back with the final 10 minutes. This is SNU Basketball. Welcome back to Bethany. The final quarter upon us. SNU leading Southeastern 49-37. SNU outscored the Savage Storm 19-12 in that period. Same five out there for SNU. Right corner Giles up top. Adams nearly lost it. Got it back. Top of the key. Reether gives it to Monahan. Posting up on Holly Lindley. Monahan spins across the paint. Off the glass. No good. Loose ball. Still loose. Adams comes up with it, and she's fouled by Grace Alverson. You could tell there was a bit of a moment there late in the third quarter where SNU started to get a little frustrated and started to take their frustration out on the Savage Storm. And that is what has led to a 12-point lead. Reether looking for help. Gets it into Monahan, left corner. Sizing up Lindley, backing her down. Out to Giles. Giles to Adams. Backing down on Wiedemann. Fades, fires, and hits. Georgia Adams, 14 points today. And the lead is 14 with 9:25 to go. Lindley struggling to get it in. Finally gets it into Hackler. Lindley across half court. Driving all the way to the right baseline. Kibiski at the scorer's table, set to check in. Next dead ball. Lindley drives to the bucket, forces it up. No good. Gets deflected out of bounds off of Wiedemann. It's SNU basketball. Wiedemann checks out. Kibiski back in. Kinsley Warden on the bench with four personal fouls. Kibiski has not committed a foul in the second half. She had two in the first 3 minutes and change of the first quarter. Hannah Giddy on the bench with four fouls for SNU and an offensive foul on Carly Gassaway for the illegal screen. That's her second. Jenna Bay coming back in. Trent May having an animated conversation with one of the officials. Giles checks out. Bay back in. Good to see her back in after taking that elbow from Holly Lindley in the third quarter. Grace Alverson pulls the trigger for three, top of the key, and rolls it in. Second triple of the game for Grace Alverson. She's got nine off the bench, and the lead is at 11, 51-40. Here's Adams, left elbow to Reether, top of the key. Reether diving. Hesitates, drives by Hackler, is bumped and fouled. Definite foul, who's it going to be on? It's going to go on Hackler. Her second. Reether going back to the line for two free throws, where she's 4-for-6 today. A full stat sheet for Lauren Reether today. 8 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists, and 4 steals. Aaron Dolan back in for Southeastern. Reether hits the first free throw. 8:23 to play. You wonder at what point Kinsley Warden checks back in with those four personal fouls. Reether missed the second one. She's missed three today now, 5 of 8. Dolan crosses over, drives all the way to the basket, put it up, and it rolls off. No good. Reether has the rebound and a foul on the Savage Storm. Going on Dolan. Just her second personal foul with 8:14 to go. 52-40. Reether across half court for SNU. 8 minutes to play. Jenna Bay holding right wing up top to Monahan. Left wing Reether. Up top Gassaway. She's open. Pulls the trigger for three. It's good! Carly Gassaway, 8 points off the bench. She's 2-for-3 from deep. And SNU continues to find production from just about everywhere. Kibiski across half court to Lindley. Lindley all the way across the court, picks up her dribble. Now she's in trouble. Reether knocks it away. Lindley didn't go get it, and Reether stole it. Reether splits a double team, a foul on Alverson up top with 7:31 to play. And that foul on Alverson, already the fourth foul on the Savage Storm with 7:31 to go. Bay checks out. Hannah Giddy comes back in with four personal fouls, and here comes Kinsley Warden with four personal fouls. Lindley checks out for Southeastern. 7:31 to play, 55-40. SNU with the lead. Inbounds comes to Reether, to Giddy at the right elbow. Giddy picks up her dribble at the foul line, needs help. Outside Gassaway, left wing. Gassaway sets her feet, hides behind the Giddy pick, just short on the three. Loose ball goes out of bounds off Hackler, and it'll stay with SNU with a fresh 20 on the clock. 7:16 to go. SNU has seized control in the second half, outscoring the Savage Storm by 10. Monahan backing down Hackler. Pivots into the paint. Pivots back to the baseline. Threw it up. Hit the back iron. No good. Monahan wanted a foul call. She's now 3 of 13 from the field. Long lead pass ahead for Hackler. It's too long, but she saved it right to Monahan. Monahan on the break. Steps around Kibiski. Scoop layup. It curls in! Oh, wow! What a shot from Emily. Here's Alverson. Open three. That's way off the mark. Kibiski the rebound. Forces it back up, and it goes in for two. Timeout, Darren Grover with 6:37 to play. 57-42, SNU with the lead. It's a full timeout. We'll take it as well and come back with more. This is SNU basketball.
SNU sets the standard for innovative servant leadership. Students from every discipline are exposed to leadership opportunities where they can thrive. In more than 45 majors, students experience true integration of faith and learning, rising to be leaders in their field. SNU is the place for educators to take the next step and earn a master's or doctorate in education and leadership, with over 400 Ed Leadership graduates serving across Oklahoma. If you're starting as a freshman or earning a master's or doctorate, SNU is the place for you.
SNU in possession out of the timeout, 6:30 to play, 57-42, Crimson Storm. Lauren Reether holding right wing, looking for help. Back up top, Gassaway. Left wing to Giddy. Giddy back to Gassaway. 10 on the shot clock. And Gassaway is bumped and fouled by Grace Alverson. Darren Grover's not pleased with the call, but that's a foul in 24 states. Gassaway at the line for two free throws. She's 5 for 6 at the line this season. Missed the first one short. It's the third foul on Grace Alverson. Gassaway hits the second. Dolan quickly into the front court. Left side, Kibiski. Kibiski. Gets it to Warden. The freshman works, drives on Monahan. Stops right of the paint. Loose ball. Giddy with the pick. Giddy in a foot race to the basket. Too strong on the layup. Monahan with it. Gets it to Reether. Outside Adams. Three-pointer on the way. Off the back iron. Gassaway tracks down the offensive rebound for SNU. Here's Giddy across the paint. Bumped by Kibiski. No call. Now Gassaway outside right wing. Behind the screen from Giddy. Hits her on the roll. To the basket. Giddy missed the shot short. Kibiski clears. Couple good looks at the basket there for SNU. None of them could fall, though. But they lead by 16 with 5.5 to go. 58-42. Here's Kibiski. Left wing, 4-3. It's online and good. SNU 3 of 11 from the field in the quarter. They've still managed to push the lead up. Monahan holding right wing. Now Giddy in the right corner. 15 on the shot clock. Giddy, again, bumped off her spot by Kibiski. No call. Here's Adams to the foul line. Tried to get it to Giddy on the roll, but Kibiski reached up and intercepted it. Here's Dolan pushing tempo. Drives right at Reether. Nearly lost the basketball. Stepping through. Fades. Rolls off. No good. Gassaway another rebound. Her third. 4:40 to play, 58-45. Southern Nazarene with the lead. Giddy holding right elbow to Reether, top of the key, behind the Giddy pick. Now hits Giddy on the roll, and she puts it in this time. No problem. Hannah Giddy into double figures with 10. The lead back to 15 at 60-45. Kabisky, left wing, takes it right at Giddy. Spin, steps through, left-hand layup, short. Giddy clears with her fifth rebound. Monahan for SNU, controlling, gives to Gassaway. Now Giddy, back up top, Georgia Adams with 12 on the shot clock. Adams drives, has it knocked away. She'll get the dribble back to Reether with 5 on the shot clock. Giddy, left elbow. Giddy, taking it to Kabisky. Step through, puts it up at the shot clock buzzer. It bounces in for 2. Right as the buzzer was sounding, Giddy puts it up and in. The lead is 17 with 3:25 to go. Kabisky pulls up, left elbow, no good. Reether seizes the board, 3:20 to play. And SNU in control, up by 17, 62-45. Georgia Adams holding right wing. Monahan wants it. Reether has it, top of the key. 12 on the shot clock for Gassaway, left wing. Gassaway behind the screen from Giddy. Bounce pass. Oh, what a feed. Giddy lays it up and in. Beautiful feed from Carly Gassaway. And you see the sophomore growing up this afternoon. Giddy with 3 straight buckets. And the lead is 19. Kabisky to the basket. Puts it up with the left hand. It somehow rolls off. No good. 2:35 to play. SNU leading 64-45. Reether pounding the dribble at the logo. Now she heads right. Comes back left behind the screen from Giddy. Another pick and roll. Another bucket for Hannah Giddy. Dolan blazing into the front court. Up top, Alverson dumps it down low to Hackler. Adams knocked it away. Hackler got it back. Adams took an elbow. And now Adams goes down. Warden hits the jumper. Monahan is down now. So we've had 2 elbows to SNU players this afternoon. We've got a timeout on the court. Adams looked like she took one on the chin. Now Darren Grover's the one out having words with the officials. Not sure what he's mad about. SNU's the one who had 2 elbows to the face today. SNU leads by 19, 66-47 with 2 minutes to play, and the officials will go to the monitor to check this particular elbow. Four straight possessions for SNU offensively. 4 straight pick and rolls with Hannah Giddy. With multiple players handling the pick part for the Crimson Storm. This beautiful offense for SNU. Is shooting just under 50% in the second half. Southeastern just 33% for the game. SNU outscoring Southeastern 36-22 in the second half. Let's take a quick look at scores from around the league. 86-38, Arkansas Tech all over the Blossoms this afternoon. Northwestern still in a tussle with East Central, only up by 5 with 4 minutes to go, 56-51. Southwestern knocks off Oklahoma Baptist, 63-61. A valiant comeback effort by the Bison. Comes up just a little bit short. The Bison trailed 25-9 after the first quarter. And outscored Southeastern 42-28 in the second half. Nearly got over the hump. Couldn't quite do it this afternoon. Henderson State going to knock off Southern Arkansas. They lead 77-58 with 1:17 to go. And again, Ouachita and Harding, their doubleheader tonight, 5:30 and 7:30 for the Tigers and the Bisons. here. It's 66-47. Crimson Storm with the lead over Southeastern Oklahoma State in our second huddle between referees and coaches. Inadvertent elbow once again is the call. It'll be SNU basketball with 2 minutes to play and a 19-point lead. Hannah Duncan back on the court along with Jillian Crawford in for the first time. Reether takes her first rest of the game. Georgia Adams remains out after an elbow to the face. Triple team comes for Monahan, and Wiedelman intercepts the pass. Here's Lindley outside Beeson left wing. Beeson outside to Warden. Warden drives to the basket. Blocked from behind by Duncan, I believe. Here comes Monahan into the front court for SNU. 1:40 to play. We'll see if they credit Duncan with a block there. It would be SNU's first of the afternoon. Monahan to Giddy. Hands back to Monahan. Kicks it out. Crawford. 15-foot jumper is blocked by Lindley. And then Lindley stepped on the sideline. Stays with SNU with 1:27 to play. Good defensive play there by Holly Lindley. Freshman Crawford out of Piedmont, Oklahoma. Now there's a discussion with the officials. Not sure what that discussion is. I think probably just the setting of the shot clock. Duncan and Crawford, the only two SNU players who have entered the game that have not scored today. Still not sure what we're actually looking at here.
Resetting the shot clock to 10 seconds.
So they're going to rule no possession for Lindley as she stepped on the sideline. So SNU basketball with 10 on the shot clock. 1:27 to play. Inbounds comes to Monahan, who gives to Giddy right elbow. To Crawford. Crawford outside to Duncan. Finds herself open. Fires a three off the back iron. Loose ball. Monahan's the one who comes up with it. Lost it in a crowd. Giddy comes up with it. And Monahan now backs it out. SNU now 11 offensive rebounds today. Monahan cut off on the drive outside to Gassaway. Here's Giddy. Giddy with four, with three. Duncan with two. Giddy forces it up at the shot clock buzzer. She banked it in. They say shot clock violation. Trent May wants them to look at it. And I think they're going to. That was really close. Definitely worth a look. Not sure what's going to happen. Anna Coakley and Kimberly Cook at the scorer's table set to check in for SNU. And they are going to go take a look at it. So we'll head to the scorer's table to take a peek if that was released in time by Hannah Giddy. It was certainly a bang-bang play. The end of this game really has slowed to a crawl with several of these reviews and discussions and elbows to the face. But the end result going to be the same. SNU moving to 18-0, leading by 19, 66-47. This will be 19 straight at home for the Crimson Storm.
Shot clock violation.
So they are going to rule a shot clock violation.
Southeastern ball. Into the game for the Crimson Storm and Coakley.
So Giddy checks out. Emily Monahan checks out. Kimberly Cook and Anna Coakley in. Cook, a junior out of Whitewater, Kansas, and Coakley, the junior out of Cremona, Italy. Wiedelman drives into the paint, and Gassaway forces the tie-up on Wiedelman. 21 on the shot clock for Southeastern. This game really turned in the third quarter. Here's Warden. Lost the ball in the paint, steps around Crawford, and puts it in off the glass. This game really turned in the third quarter when Warden went out with her fourth personal foul. And SNU able to build a double-digit lead, and they just kept expanding on it in the fourth quarter. Crawford up top. Has it now left wing behind the screen from Coakley. Crawford pulls up from the foul line and knocks in the jumper. Jillian Crawford. Has some good basketball in her blood. Sister Reagan at Harding. Sister Delaney over at Tulsa. Here's Wiedemann from the left corner for three. That's good. Her second triple of the game. She's got eight off the bench today. 14 seconds to go, and that's going to do it. 68-52, Southern Nazarene improving to 18-0. The regular season streak is now 32 games. Seven more at home for the Crimson Storm in the last 10 games. The dominant run for the Crimson Storm continues here at the Sawyer Center. 68-52, the final score is SNU outscores Southeastern 38-27 in the second half. Let's take a look at the final numbers. SNU 42% from the field today. They had a rough second quarter when they were just 3 of 11 from the field. 5 of 19 from three-point range. We talked in pregame about how SNU's been excellent shooting the three of late, and of course SNU goes 5 of 19 from deep this afternoon. Can never tee up the pregame conversations and expect them to play out the exact way that you're talking about them in the pregame show. 9 of 13 from the free throw line for SNU. Southeastern finishes the day 35% shooting from the field, 6 of 15 from three-point range, and 10 of 13 from the foul line. SNU dominated the boards this afternoon, 43-26, 12-2 on the offensive glass, but just 4 second chance points for SNU today. 4 for Southeastern. SNU in the paint, 42-20, 15 points off 12 turnovers for SNU, 9 points for Southeastern off 12 SNU turnovers. SNU 10-3 in fast break points this afternoon. Individually, Hannah Giddy leading the way for SNU today. 16 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and a steal. No blocks today for Hannah. I'd have to look up the last time Hannah didn't have a block in a game, if ever. But no blocks for Hannah or the Crimson Storm this afternoon. Certainly the first time in a very long time SNU hasn't had a block as a team. Georgia Adams coming off the bench today, played 24 minutes, 14 points, 6 rebounds for Georgia as she continues to get healthy and make an impact for this Crimson Storm team over the final month and a half of the season. Those are the only two in double figures today, but it was a well-rounded effort for the Crimson Storm. 9 points off the bench for Carly Gassaway, 9 for Emily Monahan, 9 for Lauren Reether, along with 7 rebounds, 8 assists, and 5 steals today. 5 points for Abby Giles, 2 for Jenna Bay, 2 for Jillian Crawford, and 2 for Shannon Burton. It's a complete team effort this afternoon in the win for SNU. For the Savage Storm, 11 points for Caitlin Kabisky leading the way, 8 points for Kinsley Warden, 8 for Bree Wiedelman, 9 off the bench for Grace Alverson, 2 for Lauren Beeson, 6 for Holly Lindley, 2 for Aaron Dolan, and 6 for Ashton Hackler, rounding out the scoring for Southeastern Oklahoma State. We'll step aside for a brief break. When we come back, we'll be joined by head coach Trent May and Georgia Adams. Get their thoughts on today's win over Southeastern, SNU's 5th straight over the Savage Storm and their 6th in the last 7 contests. Again, the final score, 68-52. The Crimson Storm with the win. We'll be back with more. This is SNU Basketball.
Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. SNU wins today 68-52 over Southeastern Oklahoma State. We're joined by Coach Trent May. And Trent, another solid win for your squad. Just take us through it.
Oh, man, what a great atmosphere for a Saturday, right? Good turnout, fun to play in front, you know, a lot of excited crowds to watch our girls play. Thought our girls, took us a little bit to settle into the game. Sometimes our first halves aren't the best. So we have to redirect at halftime, and sometimes some tough conversations. But they answered the bell and came out in the second half and was ready to go. And it took us a little bit, but I love the fact that we, regardless of how it looked, we won all four quarters tonight. That's a great sign of a team that just no matter what we're going to get, it's not going to be easy. And so we the path of least resistance is always in our favor. But our girls did a good job of staying in the fight like they always do and found another way to win.
Well-rounded contributions tonight across the board. Just two in double figures, but you had three others with nine. How exciting is that to see as a coach?
Love it. And in fact, one of those in double figures, Georgia Adams, who you get the pleasure of speaking to next, phenomenal job. I mean, it's just a fun story, Luke. You get really teary-eyed about what just her her perseverance and her fight. She steps in the game. She's not feeling great at all. It's her desire to play. We're going to meet that desire because we want her to play. And her 60% or 70% is better than a lot. And so, for us, we're going to give her that opportunity. She made the most of it. Her offensive rebounds, I think she had six rebounds, four offensive tonight. Those are huge. She's doing that on one leg, And so the things she's bringing to the table, and it's just a great story, man. It's just fun. It's a great energy boost when we didn't know we needed another one, but I'll take it. Very timely, and it's appreciated.
Even in that second quarter when you guys were really struggling offensively, you really relied on your defense. You never gave up the lead this afternoon. You built this program on defense. How big is it to be able to cash in on that?
Man, it's super important. The old adage, defense does win championships, and we've been a really tough defensive team in this conference, and thankfully, if the ball's not going in or you're just not an offensive sink on a given night, when you can rely on that defense and know that, hey, they're gonna have a tough time to score, man, it always keeps you in the game, keeps you in the fight.
Carly Gassaway, 9 points off the bench. We've seen her come on over the past, really this month in January. How exciting is to see the light really starting to come on for her?
Yeah, I love it, man. I mean, that girl, her heart is just, couldn't be any bigger for this program. And, it's a fun thing. She sent me a podcast today after shoot around. And, it's just one of those things that one of the premise of it was excellence, and it's excellence in all things and all things to the glory of God. She just exemplifies that every day in her attitude, her approach, her work ethic, and to her life. And she's a great example of what this university stands for, but couldn't be more thrilled for her. I love the shots, obviously, but those passes, man, those assists were something. And love that she has that vision and be able to see the floor like she does.
You got seven more here at home over the last 10. How nice is it? It probably wasn't the most fun to have eight road games to start conference play, but eight on the second half is pretty nice.
It is pretty nice, man. We're excited. I mean, there's still a lot of basketball left. I just love where our girls are at, and even in the tough times, man, our girls just push through. They just know how to compete. That's the character they have and who they are as individuals. But but basketball character matters as well, and how they perform and how they they spend a lot of time outside the court. Outside practice, developing their skill sets, and it's definitely paying off. So I'm thankful for that.
Well, Trent, congrats on the win. Look forward to seeing you on Thursday.
Yeah, God's good. Appreciate you. Thank you.
We'll be back with Georgia Adams in just a second. Welcome back. We're joined by Georgia Adams, 14 points off the bench today for the Crimson Storm in their 68-52 win over Southeastern. And Georgia, it's been a blessing to be able to talk to you at all, just given how things started at the beginning of the year. And I know that you're thrilled to be out on the court. How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling pretty good, honestly. It's just so exciting for me to be back out with the girls. I love playing with them, so yeah, there's just nothing more that I love than being out there with them. So a bit sore, but that's all right. We're managing that, so just getting through it.
Take us through what the past couple months have been for you. I mean, your senior year, your high hopes for you individually and for the team, and then you get hurt in a scrimmage. You know, how have you been able to handle that mentally?
It's been pretty tough, but, you know, my coaches and my teammates, they're looking after me, making sure that I get the care that I need, make sure I'm doing my rehab, keeping me accountable. But I've also been working really hard myself to obviously get back, because like you said, it's my senior year and I just really want to play with the girls, so yeah.
What's it been like watching, you know, this team start out 15-0 without you and now throw you back in the mix? Got to be pretty exciting, but also I'm sure that in your mind there's a little trepidation. Oh, I don't want to mess this up.
I know. I kind of was talking to Coach May about that. Like, I didn't really want to, didn't know how to go about it, but I kind of just am trying to play my role coming off the bench, providing something off the bench, a bit of a spark, so yeah.
Big win for you guys today. It seemed like about midway through that third quarter, something seemed to click for you guys, where you guys, the intensity ramped up. What was going on in those moments that allowed you to build that double-digit lead in the third quarter?
We get a bit of a revving at halftime sometimes, so that definitely helps. But we came together in that third quarter, and we just really dialed in on what we had to focus on, our keys for the game. And from there, like, when we just follow the scout, know what we're doing, it just explodes for us, and that's how we get easy buckets, and our defense really fires up as well.
How are you guys just handling all this? You know, you're 18-0 now. You're winning big. You've certainly been challenged at times, but you've come through every time. How are you guys handling, you know, the hype and just all the winning?
I mean, obviously it's really nice, but we're just really trying to dial in and stay focused, trying not to give in to the noise a lot of it. But yeah, we just keep fighting. We don't want to give up, so we obviously want to keep it on a roll, so that's what we're going to keep doing.
Absolutely. Well, Georgia, congrats on the big win today, and we look forward to seeing more of it on Thursday.
Thanks, Luke.
As Georgia Adams will be back with the start of the men's game here in just a couple minutes.